Welcome back to another episode of the Low IQ Podcast.
Episode 20?
Episode 20. Look at that. Good, 20 episodes into season 3.
Yeah.
Now, we have a guest. Well, is he a guest? I don't know. Who is he? Really?
Don't know.
Introduce yourself.
Hi, everybody. it's a pleasure to be here, man.
Yeah.
A little make-a-wish. I'm thankful that I've got my little start-up from you lot. Appreciate it.
Danny Aarons.
Woo! Fucking Danny Aarons. All over the block at the moment.
Let me tell you, I want to start by saying that even since the last time I saw you, you've grown up.
I'm cooking, man.
You have grown up. Because we saw you back, I don't know, like a few months ago.
Yeah. It was more than that. When did you do the Fellas? You did a Fellas.
The month before that.
It was a little while ago.
I remember. That was like weird stage of my life.
Well, that's what I was literally saying to them. I was like, I walked up to you and I was like, fucking hell.
Don't
hideous.
Touch me.
Oh,
don't
nice.
Touch
yeah. me. Okay,
gross.
Nice, yeah.
So I had to go to the bathroom. You shook my hand. I had to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, wash it.
Flee myself.
That's fair enough. Yeah.
But look at you now.
No, but
he's
fucking gorgeous.
I'm only joking. But now, what have you done?
This is the thing. I ain't done nothing.
You must have done,
like,
done
legit, something. I've done nothing.
Your
like,
facial structure.
I've been looks maxing, mate.
What does that mean?
I've been looks maxing.
What the fuck does that
mean? You
don't
know what looks maxing is?
Never heard of that in my life.
Start mewing.
Bro.
Start.
No way.
What the hell does that mean?
I've been looks maxing. Mate, you ain't a looks maxer.
Are you speaking English? I don't know what you mean.
Nah, trust. The people will know. Looks maxing.
Looks maxing.
Looks maxing.
You don't know what the fuck.
I know what mewing is.
That's a bunch of bullshit, by the way. I don't know. I've been going gym. I've been like.
So you don't mew?
I mew. Hell yeah. Everyone should mew. Mew is just, sorry, this is such a weird combo to start with.
I know.
Mew is just when you breathe through your nose.
Oh, wait, what?
That's it. You put your tongue.
Oh,
your
you're
tongue.
Not a mouth breather anymore.
I was a mouth breather. That's actually probably it.
That's why you're all fucked
up. You know
up.
Why? Yeah. I owe a lot to Ethan Bazinga, you know. Ethan Bazinga took the piss out of my posture, so that's now better.
Oh, yeah, you were like a hunchback.
I used to.
Yeah.
So now,
yeah.
And he also took the piss out of me for breathing with my mouth. So now I no longer do.
This nice is why, friend.
No, honestly, this is why I like bullying. I'm a very big advocate of. Like, verbal bullying, I'm
it's
all
great.
Over it. Like,
it's genuinely. Fucking brilliant. Everyone bully. Everyone
verbally.
Bully.
Verbally, and only things that you can change. Don't go after, like, that's disabilities true. Or that.
Yeah.
But, well, like,
no small dicks but, or anything. Don't
nah,
bully about
nah, I thought that that's a bit childish. But, like, when we speak about weight, hair... Everything can
he's changed his hair a little bit.
I was gonna. You're the mullet.
The
mullet guy.
Mullet's probably the best thing that's happened to me.
I was gonna say it suits your
head
face
shape.
And head
the,
shape.
The
yeah.
outrageous head shape. Yeah. Like, I used to just be like every other kid, go Turkish barber, skin fade.
Yeah. Glasses as well. You used to have.
Yeah, had glasses on.
What's happened with the glasses?
Contacts now, mate.
That's what I do.
Contacts.
Contact like, queens.
I used to wear contacts all the time, and then one got stuck in my eye for like 3 days. So then I went like, and I just stopped wearing contacts for years. I was like, I'll go back to it now. Do you know what I mean? Like, because it helps.
That is a rumor where, you know, when they say it goes behind your eye,
no.
It don't go behind your eye.
No, it doesn't, mate.
It doesn't because there's skin that goes around your eye.
And what do you mean the skin?
So
the eyelid?
No. The center of your eye.
What do you mean? What? The skin on your eye? All right,
no, the skin in your eyeball. Oh, the center of it, there's skin that attaches to your face, mate.
Is that real?
Yeah.
Oh, let me tell you a fact then, right? So when I'm looking at this, everything is upside down.
Come on.
Okay, what?
Genuinely. I learned this.
Lights or whatever. It reflects.
No, not really.
I know what you're on about.
No, it's the same with a camera, right? So this camera's seeing us upside down. Right?
Yeah.
Because it's the way the lens works.
Sure.
But our brains flip it.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm saying.
So you're not seeing it upside down then?
No.
You can't see what your brain sees before.
No, but the brain sees it as upside down and it switches it.
Yeah.
Sure.
It's real.
But speaking of looks, right? Can you see this little blood patch here? Can you see that? Little blood patch on my eye?
I actually can. When you do that,
So,
what happened, man?
Earlier today, I had like this little skin tag on my eye.
Ooh.
And I went to a doctor, got it cut off.
Ooh.
He jabbed
it
with them.
He mentioned that.
Oh, you said that?
Yeah.
Did I say that?
You said, his
eye
cut or something. Yeah. I was like, yeah, sure.
And you just went along with it. Fine. Just getting his eye out or something. No, but they injected it with local anesthetic, went numb, and they cut
in your eye, they like needed
in
it.
In my eyelid.
That's
long.
That's a long.
Well, you were awake?
Yeah. Mate, skin.
How is he supposed to do it when he's asleep with his eyes closed?
What? Wait, what?
You don't sleep with your eyes closed?
Yes.
Some people don't.
So let's have a conversation here. When your eyes are closed,
yeah,
you can't operate on the eye.
Of course,
because it's closed.
Yeah, but I'm not operating on my own eye.
What are you talking about?
Cole, you have something in your eye here.
Yeah.
So when you close your eye, you can no longer...
I see the confusion. You think in, but he's talking on. You think it's in the eye.
It's on my eye.
On the eye. That's where we're confused.
Apologies.
But
apologies.
Did you see that video going viral recently of that surgeon? He put this woman under, what is it? Aesthetics. Anesthetics.
Yeah.
And she was asleep and all that. Or was she somewhat awake? Yeah, she must have been awake. Anyway, so he was doing open heart surgery or some shit. And she was going, oh, fuck. And he twatted her. Punched her in the face.
No.
Yeah, look it up. Real life.
Wow. I thought you were going to say, have you seen that video? This is grim stuff, right?
This is a real video.
This is real video, yeah. It's mad. So this doctor, yeah, is operating on this woman. And there's like a little sheet here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And this woman's like, yeah, right, with local anesthetic in her mouth. She's out. Hold she's up. Out cold.
Is it a video?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I thought
she's sleeping. No, she's sleeping, yeah. And this guy gets his willy out.
Fantastic.
And he puts it in her mouth.
Great news.
And then he goes to he gets caught.
Where do you see these videos?
I haven't seen that video.
It's horrible. It's horrible.
That
yeah.
I haven't
seen
nice, that.
Have you seen that video?
Yeah.
Why have you? That must be illegal.
Someone's definitely beat off to it. Let's be honest.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, 100%.
Yeah. 100%.
There is. There's freaks out there.
That's just mental. Well, yeah, but you've watched the video. That's freaky.
You're
not in a freaky way.
You're like promoting that.
No, because
you just told millions of people to go and watch
that's
that.
That's I wanked like, to that.
Well,
shit,
millions of people, probably not.
Well, but. hundreds.
Just 10 people. So.
Do you watch gore videos?
I used to be that sick kid in school. You know, in school, you always had that one person sending like beheading videos.
I do.
That was me. Wizard. That he was does me. It all the
I'll
time.
I'll be honest, like, it gave me a kick, man.
I hate that.
It gave me a kick.
Yeah, it does.
Like, you're just in a random group chat with the boys. They're speaking about, oh, you want to play football? Beheading video.
I can't deal with that.
Or, like, have you ever sent your own poo?
I mean, that's standard.
That's standard. That's,
oh, is it?
I've got a great
that's
video for
standard,
you.
Man.
I did that too much.
No, but I don't do that anymore. I used to. Go on, there was a website called ratemypoo.com. It used to be
I used to
do that like once a week.
Really?
Like, you know, like once a week you have a good poo.
What, you can upload
you
put, your...
Yeah, can you post... Are we allowed to put a poo video on YouTube?
I probably wouldn't, mate. But do you want to show your own poo
video? No, you can't see my arsehole. You didn't just see the poo.
No, but poo is poo. Like, nah.
Yeah, really?
Poo. Nah, I wouldn't. Yeah. Nah.
Okay.
Keep that for the boys, man.
All right, well, I'll show you boys after
Thank
this.
You,
it's
mate.
Fucking sick.
That's great. Right,
yeah,
it's like literally King Kong's finger. Honestly, that long. And you know when you have a shit... And you're like getting stressed because your ass wants to cut it, but you have to like
focus
so it doesn't cut.
I've been there.
Yeah. Genuinely, I was so in my body that I wasn't letting my asshole cut the shit. So it was just going for like ages.
Yeah, it does that.
I had a horror poo experience yesterday.
Oh God. No.
I was at a shoot, wrapped up. I was holding it in for hours.
Wrapped up?
Like, you know, the shoot they wrapped up.
Oh,
it was done.
I thought you meant you were wrapped up.
So it was like, no, it was like, we got there at like 9, finished at 4, and from 9 in the morning, I had to poo. But I was like, I like holding it in sometimes. Yeah. So 4 PM hits, everyone's like, cool, cameras are packing up. I've took my chance, gone in the toilet. I've done my business. It was a long, like, similar to the Kung Fu. Similar to the, you know, it's like,
big poo.
Yeah. It's a large, man. Went to flush.
No, wasn't happening.
I'll be honest,
that is
wasn't happening.
Worst.
So what I just did was just whack a load of toilet roll, left.
Oh dear.
I went, hey, lovely to see everybody. You said goodbye. I got out of there so quickly. So if anyone was on that shoot, check the toilet. There is a large.
They're the worst when the toilet
it's
doesn't
such
work.
Such a bad situation, man.
Or if you're round... Like a girl's house.
I would never.
Do you not? You don't poo.
Do you poo?
In front of a girlfriend.
Not round like, and like, not even like, even friends. I wouldn't. Nah.
I had a poo earlier in the little downstairs disabled.
Yeah, but that's fine.
This is like workplace. Mm. Any like friends, if I'm round the house, girlfriend, never.
Okay. Do you fart in front of your girlfriend?
That's a bit early, man.
Ever.
It's
have you ever
early.
Then?
What about your ex?
Yeah. Yeah, I've ripped ass, man.
Yeah,
he's ripped,
I love
I've
it.
Ripped ass.
I do. But the I feel like oven.
That's fine.
Mm.
That's I thought. This might be a bit sexist. Ooh.
Yeah,
get, this, get him on camera now.
No, but I feel like the girls hide Stinky. It. Like the girls will be years in a relationship still not fine.
No, oh, because yeah. I tell you why. Because they actually reek. Genuinely, yeah, way
I think,
worse.
I think it depends, man. It depends on what they're digesting and that.
Yeah.
I mean, what there's some clean is. Girls that will just fart out
the cleaner,
for hours,
the cleaner, the dirtier, they say.
But really? I prefer my girlfriend not to smell shit, like, around me.
Do you know what I mean? Because it's funny.
Nah.
There's surely a stage in your relationship where just stuff like that's funny instead of like, ew.
Yeah.
You know?
But I've been with my girlfriend for 3 years and I let it out all the time.
3 years is, mate. If I'm not doing it in 3 years time, come on. Like I'll be ripping ass.
Mm. He's going to be ripping. You're going to be shitting on her head.
Like vibrating, like bum cheeks vibrating, like proper. Yeah. You fuck it, man.
So you're recently in a relationship, right?
Hell yeah, man.
Here we go.
Out of one into the other.
I don't know how you describe that.
Sorry. All right, fine. It was like, was it a short period?
It was a quick transfer, to be honest.
Transfer deadline day. It was like from Colchester United to Man United.
I haven't seen your ex.
I've got nothing but love and respect for my ex.
Cut that out. That's fucking
good. You keep that in.
Really?
It's fine. Because I don't know her. It's nothing on you because I don't even know your name. What's her name?
I don't know.
Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Get off the subject.
But what I was going to say.
I apologize, but I don't know what you look like. So it's not actually offensive because you could be fitter.
Yeah.
Not my.
What I was going to say. What was I going to say now? You fucking put me off the track here.
About his new missus.
About your new missus. Yeah, what was I going to say about that? Do you remember?
Do you like her?
Do you like her?
She's calm, man.
Mm.
Yeah. She's calm.
Oh, I know what I was going to say.
Here we go.
Was she. Her ex is Digger D, right?
Yeah.
Are you not scared he's going to come and bang you out?
See, now, this is the thing, man. Like, if someone gets with my ex, I'm not like angry.
But no, there's different types of people in this world.
That's true. Gangsters. I mean, I'm just like. I ain't done nothing wrong.
That's true.
You know what I mean? She was on the market. She was free agent.
Mm-hmm.
Sweeped her up, mate.
You swapped
it. Do you know what I mean? Agent. Like,
when? How long was it until you became official?
It was just before Christmas. So we
before
kept...
Before Christmas?
Yeah, before Christmas. And it was I'll be honest, advice to anyone in love or... Mm. In the process, oh,
he's in
of
love.
Love.
He's in love.
I'm in love, man.
Yeah,
I've been
really.
In love.
I want to ask you this.
We'll go to that. If you're, the cool kids call it a situationship, right? Where it's just like, oh, what are we?
Is blah, that blah, blah. Friends with benefits type thing?
No. Situationship is like, oh, we are exclusive. But we don't want to say girlfriend boyfriend.
Mm.
So that's how it was for a little bit, and I was just like. It's too close to Christmas, man. So I was at the weird stage, like, oh, do I get her a Christmas present? Does she get me a Christmas present? So I would say, if you're in that bit, wait until after Christmas. But to be fair, we did exchange gifts. Yeah. She bloody niced me big time. So
what did you get?
I'm not a shoe guy, but she got me some nice shoes, man.
What did you get her?
I got her Cartier ring.
Fuck off. She got the better deal here.
Yeah,
I think.
I'm pretty sure that's better
mate,
than a pair of shit shoes.
No, I'm not doing it justice. These are like Travis Scott shoes or whatever.
Travis Scott is.
And I'm not a shoe guy, but I go out in public and people are like,
yeah,
they're nice.
They're rare.
Like, hey, my girl bought me them. Do you know what I mean? Like,
just to add to that, because you're right here. So one of my mates, you know him, he is seeing this girl and for Christmas, we recently went on holiday and he was like, oh, what do I get her? And they weren't together at the time.
Mm.
And we were like, oh, just get her something small. You're not together. Do you know what I mean? So he was like, all right. He picked up a mug from this like corner shop that said Prague on it. Anyway, it got to Christmas Day and she was the first to do the gift. And she got him a brand new iPhone.
Nice.
Oh, dear.
And here's a £6 mug. Yeah, that's
barely
six.
Oh,
tricky one, isn't it?
That's
really?
Tricky.
A tricky one.
So why don't we figure out what is the acceptable thing to do here? Because I think...
What you'd have to do, this is what, you know, you'd have to be like, oh, I got you this, but I've also got you something else that's coming.
Yeah.
And at that point you panic and just buy... Price high to low,
yeah.
Click it.
He did. I mean? Like, he got her Man United tickets.
There you go. That's always a play. But, that is always a play. Yeah. I fumbled. I got my brother like a good gift for Christmas, but then I'm like, it's not, I need more.
You need more.
So I'm just like, oh, you know, I got you tickets to this. Because I can just buy that on the day. but it's not until a few months.
True. Or the more I go with thoughtful. Like if it, do you know what I mean? Because girls,
they're
like,
the issue, man.
Do you know what I mean?
Not with it.
They love them. Like when it always comes down to Christmas, I feel like my parents prefer my brother's presence because he's just like, works a 9-to-5, humble, whatever. Mm. I'm humble as well. Oh, but like he doesn't have money.
Yeah.
So like he actually has to put thought into it and he gets sick presents. Mm. And then I just get like, got my mum like diamond earrings and blah, blah, blah. And it's like,
blah, blah, blah.
It's nice.
Diamond earring or blah, blah, blah.
But it's not thoughtful.
Ferrari or whatever.
Like, oh, she likes jewellery, but it's not like thoughtful.
Mm.
So I feel like they prefer my brother's presents, you know?
Genuinely, yeah. When I get my girlfriend gifts, she always prefers the thoughtful one.
Yeah.
They do, didn't they?
But girls? I don't. I hate the thoughtful ones.
You just want money.
I want the big money one.
Yeah. Lambo.
Yeah.
Or something, yeah. I mean, do you like the thought? So if Tennessee, right, she comes up to you and she says, Danny, mate, there is a Ferrari here.
Yeah.
Right?
Has she got an accent?
That's exactly how she sounds, actually.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, that's how she says it. Ferrari, right? She's got a Ferrari here.
Yeah.
Well, I've got you a box of 20 of the things that I love about you.
Ooh. So she's lost the accent on that one.
Yeah.
Right. 20 of the things. I prefer thoughtful ones, like for real.
Over a Ferrari, that's not real.
In that situation, I'm having a Ferrari, don't you know? Because she could just text me that. Do you know what I mean? But I'd prefer a little notebook or, do you know what I mean? Like something cringe. I'd prefer that than—
To be fair.
Than that stuff.
I'm
coming
round to it. But I was going to say, so you've been together, so Christmas, so that's 2 months.
It's not— 2 months.
A month, isn't it?
What?
Nah, not even.
When are we?
We ain't even had
Where
our...
are we? Where
nah,
are
we're, not even, we're not even a month in, man.
Wait, what?
We're not even, it's not been a month since Christmas.
When are... We're in... What month?
We're in January, brother.
Are we?
It's like January the whatever.
18th, isn't it?
Oh,
yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah, like...
Oh, yeah, we're January. Oh, shit.
We're new, man.
You're 2 weeks.
You're an idiot.
Yeah.
So you said, oh, I've been loving her.
Have
you told her you love her?
She told me first, man.
No
way.
Oh, come on.
Well, I don't know, man. Like, that's not... I said, love you, right?
Oh, that's not real.
Oh.
And then she hit me back with the I love you. So okay. I was like, I fucking won, man.
Yeah.
I won.
You said it. You manipulated her.
You're a manipulator. Well done.
She said it straight after you went love you.
Nah. See, now this is the part, I'll air myself out. So I said, love you. She laughed. Fucking laughed.
Yeah, no, she wins then.
To be fair, it was like, quite early on, and I was like, oh yeah, I'm joking.
And then
I was like, calm, I ain't saying shit anymore. I'll wait for her to say it.
Yeah.
And then she said it week after.
Was that your way of trying to say?
That was feeling out the process.
And she laughed in your face.
And I was like, okay, fuck, this ain't going as what I thought. But then like a week later, she like, I love you.
Might be pressure. Like,
what was your reaction?
I said, fuck yeah, man, get in there. And I said, I love you.
Oh, it's all,
we're doing the cringy stuff. Yeah. Well, I don't want to air out everything.
No, well, do
you know, I'm like, I love you.
Shit.
She's like, I love you more. And I'm like, no, I love you more, Pookie Bear.
No, you don't.
I'm like, mummy.
Oh, God.
Mate, we're at that level now, man.
Well, I've never been at that level. No one's been at that level.
No, I hate that.
Sorry to hear, man.
He hates that.
Sorry to hear.
Did you ask her out?
How did that come about? Yes.
Because that's the most awkward
bit. Yeah. Wow. Okay. So we went on like a few dates or whatever.
Mm.
And like, I told her, like, I want you to be my girlfriend, but timing's a bit tough. Because remember what I told you earlier? I was just like, Christmas is coming up, then New Year's. Is like, if we're going to have anniversary, I ain't going to have no money left. You know what I mean? That's anniversary, then Christmas, then New Year's, then Valentine's.
Oh yeah, fuck that.
Yeah.
So then I dropped her back home, like saying like, oh yeah, just basically saying what I just said.
Mm.
Then I was driving home and I'm like, fuck, man, I can't be arsed. So I just, I hate how I did it, but I text her. I'm like,
no, you can't. Nah, but you
are the one. No, but it's because we already spoke about it. So I didn't ask her out. I just said, actually, do you want to just not wait and become my girlfriend? She said,
become my girlfriend or some shit?
She said, hell yeah. So,
hell yeah.
And now it's love.
Now you love each other.
Look at that.
That's crazy.
Insane. So this is for the long haul, this girlfriend.
I hope so, man. People are saying like it's a PR thing and like, it's all that. I'm chilling, man. Like,
even if it was, if you're fucking her, that's brilliant.
What? It's a win-win.
It's a win-win.
It's a win. Nah, like, I'm,
but that's
I'm
not how PR stunts work, Cole.
Yeah, no, people are genuinely saying, I'll go around hers, take a picture, go home.
Yeah, that's what
that's PR. What people and like I hear it, like, don't get me wrong, I hear it. I hear how people are saying that. But then at the same time, like, it's a weird one. Like, when I'm streaming, all they are like, so like, oh, when's 10 coming on stream? When are you gonna put her in a vid? When's, and I'm like, okay, one sec. It's either a PR stunt or like, we can't, like, if I do that, then people are saying it was a PR stunt, it's a PR. So like, it's a weird, like, obviously my first ever public relationship. So I'm just like, I don't know how to go about it, but mate, I'm in it for the long run.
Have you been in many relationships?
Nah, this is my second one.
Shit.
This is my second relationship. Mm. So like, I'm young, man. Like, I feel like people are scrutinizing me for stuff I've done, but like, at the end of the day, I'm 21. Like, let's be fair, most guys have done exactly this. It just hasn't been online. Like, you know what I mean? Like, so I don't know, man. I don't know.
What if, so you didn't go uni?
Nah, fuck off, right?
You didn't eat that.
Never, man.
Waste of time and money. Do you ever think, right, you're in this relationship.
Yeah.
You got all these hoes that are like at the feet of you now. Yeah.
Right.
What happens if, like, I don't know, like an 11 out of 10 comes.
Already got one, man.
Good answer.
I already got one.
A 12 out of 10 comes.
I already got one. No, you know what? It's cringe. It's cringe.
No, that's good.
But I do not find any other girl attractive.
Same with me.
Genuinely. Yeah. Like, no, I'm even like, no, I know. Genuinely, not even like slightly.
Yeah. That's not what love is. That's what love is.
Lightly, man. So I'm chilling, man. I'm chilling.
That's fucking brilliant.
Love.
That is love. We're not love.
We've gone off topic because I was going to ask about how you did the weight loss, and we went on to a million different other things.
The weight loss was easy, man. Just walked.
Well, you didn't do any special.
I did not go gym or nothing there.
You weren't that fat, were you?
Yeah, I was a big boy. I was a big boy.
Can we get a picture of young Danny?
Come on. Nah, I was a big boy. I was the biggest boy. I was like 17 stone.
Way bigger.
I was a big. Big chungus boy. Yeah. Like,
look, if you compare to him now to that.
I lost 35 kg.
Oh, wow.
Just from walking.
Wait, how much did you weigh?
I don't know in kg. I was 240 pounds and I'm now 170.
It's got to be like 100 kg.
Yeah, I don't know the kgs, but.
10. Light.
Yeah, just walk.
Yeah,
like,
actually, Jack, how much
I'm at 95 now. I am.
A bit more.
No, I am.
Nah, he's not in the three digits.
No.
Nah, I was in the three digits a month ago.
You're doing well.
Yeah.
Cheers, mate.
Jesus. No, you're doing well. You just carry on. Just do what you did. Just walk, man. Just do something a bit productive and walk. Yeah, that's all you got.
Walking's sweet, man. But now I'm going gym and training.
Did
like,
you do a diet in that?
Yeah, of course. No, mate, you can't lose weight without a diet.
What was your diet?
Calories. I had 2,000 calories.
Really?
So, yeah, I'm not like on this like, what is it? Like only eat.
Keto or something.
Yeah, keto or only eat like certain types of food. I was still having takeaways and all that. Like just stay with your calories, innit? It's not hard. Mm.
Yeah, that's
very
true.
Easy.
Just and, deficit.
And on the mewing thing, I thought mewing was where,
This is about half an hour ago.
No, because I used to do this thing when I was younger where you like every night you're like this and you go.
No, no one's doing that. Jaw exercises.
Yeah, jaw exercises.
That's when you're too far down.
That's what I thought.
Just
mewing.
In bed going.
Probably part of looks maxing. Oh, I also. This is how you help mouth breathing.
Yeah.
I tape up my mouth and put a strip on my nose when I'm sleeping.
Strip of what?
Like a nose strip.
Like a
so it opens
one.
Up the canal.
Oh.
That helps a lot.
So that actually, what does mouth breathing, does it make this bit weird?
It's like, there was a study when like, if you have a kid and you teach them to breathe with their mouth or whatever, you don't stop them breathing from their mouth. The whole, it's awful.
Their jaw goes back in.
Yeah. You can know, if you walk down the street and just looked at everybody's side profiles, you'll see who breathes with their mouth or not.
That's crazy.
I'm probably still one of them. I'm speaking like I'm past it, but like, We're getting it now. Do you know what I mean?
Your voice, I can hear an airy sort of like Harry Kane. Sort of a little
don't
bit.
Don't sash
No, just 10% of your voice.
I've got Invisalign as well.
That's what it is.
So that has fucked me, to be honest with you.
Oh, mate, you're going to be paying off that then.
Yeah. That's the final bit, I think.
That's the final.
Decent teeth.
And I think keep the money.
Mate, it ain't going.
It's in trend now.
It's not
Italian
going
Italian batch gets... Girls of edits of him because he's got a mullet,
and I'm gonna probably perm it soon. Mm. Get it curly.
What does that mean?
I've also curly. Noticed your fashion sense.
Yeah, I'm now trying. I mean, you've got me in this robe, but like, yeah I'm trying. It's the girlfriend effect, isn't it? That's what people are saying, man. Like,
yeah, you need to spruce it up.
Mm. I was basically chilling with my boys, and they were like,
Sort it out.
You can't be wearing Sidemen hoodies around her. Do you know what I mean? And like, but the thing is, she's calm. Like, she'd be like, of course you can. Like, do you know what I mean? But like, it's like, You gotta cook a little bit.
At least for the first bit, then you can start
then
dipping
you can get
on
comfortable
the effort.
And yeah, whack the Sidemen on. Like.
When's her birthday?
5th of November.
Oh, you got time.
Nah, but do you know the only reason I know that?
Mm.
Fucking, she's got it tattooed on her.
She's got her tattoo.
Just in case she forgets.
Gets it, yeah.
Just in case.
He's got stupid tattoos. Hold up. All right. Guess his tattoo. I'm going to say it's the most basic tattoos you could possibly get.
Ooh.
It's wrong.
Ooh.
What is the most Essex basic?
Have you got
tattoos?
Live, laugh, laugh on your back?
Yeah, just near a tramp stamp on my top.
Wait, what's the most basic tattoo?
Yeah.
You won't get it.
If
it's not
you
that
see
basic.
Anyone from Essex, they'll be having this tattoo.
You don't.
I don't know, man. I need a clue. Better clue than that.
What's a good clue? Where am I going?
I don't even know what the fuck that is.
Where are you going?
Where am I going? Let me have a look at my.
You have a phone?
No.
I don't have a compass.
Let me have a look at my...
Not?
I don't have a compass, you twat.
I thought you do have a compass.
No, I've got coordinates.
To what?
Oh, I thought it was
Kuala Lumpur Airport.
Why?
That's mental.
Because that's not mental when I tell you why.
Go on.
This better be good.
It's where I made my first TikTok.
Awful.
No, it's awful, not. Because awful. It means something. People that's be like, why? That's awful. Weird. And then I'll be like, oh, that's really
that's
good.
It's not what, you know, George Baggs, he's got a tattoo of the TikTok logo.
That's insane.
Okay, that's way
that,
worse than
that. That's, yeah, that's
the
bad.
TikTok logo.
But you've also got a huge dragon on your back, but it's all black.
Not a dragon.
What is it?
This guy doesn't know me. It's a fucking bird.
Oh, it looks like a dragon.
Dragon's a bird. Dragons fly, isn't it?
A dragon is a carnival.
Carnival, is it? Yeah. This guy knows what he's talking about. But going on to the Sidemen, I was going to say, recently, it's like the past, what, like 5 months? Like you were big before.
Yeah.
But you've like, you're bigger.
I owe a lot to the Sidemen. Like they were my first like big break, man. Like the Sidemen have helped me.
How long ago was that?
Ooh, I mean, I've always been like in like their second channel vids, like the Among Us and that, but it was only recently they-
Were you?
Yeah, mate, I'm an Among Us-
connoisseur.
Like, yeah, I'm him, man. So like, I'm in them, but then like they put me in like a main one just as a little feature, like as a guest. Mm. And then obviously the 20 versus two, that
blew
hooked.
Up, bro.
How many views?
It's on like 9 mil at the moment, right?
Yeah, I think that can get a lot, man. I'm very happy with that. Like,
yeah, but it's like, what caused that? Is it because you're like moving a bit away from the FIFA stuff, aren't you?
Mate, it's literally just saying yes to everything.
Yeah.
So like, I don't know how it boiled down to getting on a Sidemen, but it must have just been like, oh, saying yes to someone small and then they knew someone else and then just doing and it just snowballs. Do you know what I mean? Like, I just said yes to everything. Like, literally, I do everything. Like, I've never said no to something.
I was
going
to say to you, because when we did the Sidemen shoot, I asked you about how many things you're filming.
Yeah.
And it was like a fucking ridiculous
amount. Mate, I'm that's advice to everyone. Just do everything.
But do you not think you're going to get burnt out, or you just don't believe?
I love it, man. Yeah, I genuinely love it. Like, this ain't work, innit?
I do think being burnt out is a bit of like, you only get burnt out if you let yourself get burnt out. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. I feel like if you don't like it, then it's very easy to. Yeah, but I wake up, like, when I have nothing to do on the day, I'm like, fuck. Mm. I'm so bored. I'm lazy.
Yeah, it's
like,
boring.
So I do as much as I can, man.
You know what? I did a experiment. Have you seen the film Yes Man?
No.
Jim Carrey?
Nah.
Oh. Seen that?
Where he literally, he's like saying no to everything. And then someone says, there's like a genie comes down. And is like, you have to say yes to everything now. Yeah. And he has to say yes to everything. And his life like changed. Very good. And then like when I was like 16, I did that. I literally,
Well, you said yes to everything.
Near enough.
Well, it's either a yes or no, yeah.
Yeah, I did, yeah.
Everything.
Well, the thing is, I didn't tell my mates I was going to say yes or anything. Otherwise, they'll be like, suck my dick. And I'll be like, yes. And then I'll have to suck his dick.
Yeah.
Right. But I said yes to all plans and stuff.
There you go.
And then I was like, this is buzzing. And then I stopped after a week or something.
Why'd you stop?
Oh, so it wasn't even a long time.
I would end up dying if I said, like, if I carried that on. Imagine if I carried that on till now. Then you'd be like, you'd take the piss.
Yeah, I would.
I'd be dead. So.
Huh.
Well,
there you go. You should do that.
So what are your plans now? Are you moving away? I like your FIFA video. I watch a lot of FIFA.
Mate, I still do FIFA. Like, I have a second channel where I upload daily on FIFA.
Yeah,
so
you've
like,
got content all over it. But I saw on the fellas, don't you have like 12 employees or some shit?
Nah, we're more now, man. We're more. We've had a few. I was trying to think, but like, I, the thing is, I don't see it as like employees. Like,
because they work at home and
stuff. I mean, they're just like friends that I've paid to help me. But like, we're probably on, honestly, we're close to 20, man.
That's
2024 has been a good start.
And you,
man,
pay them like proper?
They're full time. They are all
20 full time.
They are all full time. Yeah, yeah. Obviously, they're not all on the same wage. Like, I have.
But is it all above minimum salary?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, yeah. I'm not giving a minimum wage. Like, so nah, some people are on fucking NASA salary, mate.
What's
like,
a NASA salary? Do they earn
a lot?
Is it
a lot? Like, my main editor, he's living fucking life.
Do you have money for yourself, or is it all just going?
Yeah, man. I mean, personally, me, no, I ain't got nothing. The company,
oh, the big company,
the company's cooking.
We've got nothing.
Danny Aarons, he's on 12 grand a year, mate.
Yeah, okay? Yeah, well,
but the company's cooking, man. Yeah, like, no, but mate, this, like, the reason I give all these jobs out and that is because it helps grow more. Like,
I could
not have another editor, save a bit of money, but then long term, I'll be making more by getting someone else in, you know?
100%. And bashing out the content. Yeah. Easy, do you know what
that's
mean?
It.
So, we've got a hypothetical here.
Okay.
Okay, so you have a single penalty against the Premier League goalkeeper.
Right.
You score, you go on to have a beautiful relationship with Tennessee.
Right.
You miss, she leaves you for Angry Ginge.
Oh.
You can either bring on the responsibility and take it yourself or pick one of us to take it, but against the Sunday League keeper. Which do you choose?
That's easy. I'd kick, man, that's me.
Yeah?
Mm. Nah, mate, I'd score a penalty.
Yeah.
What's a Premier League goalkeeper doing compared to a Sunday League?
It's
a penalty.
Let's say it's...
That's true.
It's a penalty.
I could score a penalty. I don't even play football.
I'd argue the Sunday League keeper would be better because he'd be getting in your head, he'd be screaming abuse. Premier League goalkeepers, they're like respectful, you know?
Yeah.
That's true.
So I'd just pick on like Nottingham Forest goalkeeper and just smack it top bins.
Yeah, mate. That's... Okay, let's say a free kick with
free
a
kick
wall.
Is fucked. Free kick
there
is...
There we go. Free kick
free
with a wall.
Free kick's bad,
a
man.
A free person wall.
Right.
And it's a Van der Sar in goal in his prime.
He's a bit, okay.
prime Van
yeah, that changes things a lot, there man. It's my relationship, so I still have to back myself.
There we go.
True, no offense to you lot, but.
Are you actually good at football though?
Nah.
You're all right. You're better than like
I'm okay,
an average
like,
person.
I'd say I'm literally average.
Really?
I'd say I am average footballer.
Because I'd say we're
shit.
Well below average.
Not well below. I'd say we're just average.
I wouldn't say we're average, but I've got a good question though.
Right.
Right. Let me think of how this is worded. You can answer this as well.
Thanks.
Right. So you've got a girlfriend. Both have girlfriends, right?
Okay.
Comprende? Your girlfriend, would you rather they cheated on you? And this is like, they have to do it, right?
So you go up to them, you have to cheat on them.
Yeah. 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 So I'm the genie and I put a spell on them.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
And the spell is you either have to cheat with your best friend or your worst enemy. Who are you picking?
Wait, my best friend.
So you got a best friend.
That's a hard one, man. Hard. That's a tricky one.
Who would you
one.
Rather they cheat?
So my best friend.
Your best
my
friend.
Best friend.
Or your worst
or
enemy.
Or my worst enemy. Yeah.
Do you actually have an enemy?
That's it. Like, generally, I don't... Doherty. Jack Doherty.
He's a wanker.
Well, don't worry. If you don't know him, well done.
Oh, he is a toss,
well done if you don't know him.
What does he do?
You'll know him. He's that little American.
Trust me, it's
American
a pleasure
kid.
You don't know him.
Okay,
it's a pleasure.
Have you seen the video of the security banging that guy out for no reason?
That's, you might have done. He's just a little twat.
Let's say him then.
Oh, fuck that. No,
him
I'm the Angry Ginge here.
Angry Ginge.
I'd have to. I can't have her going anywhere near Jack Doherty.
You've got ginger pubes in Tennessee's family.
No, but Ginger's. I'd shake Ginger's hand after.
Would
you?
Would
you? Like, yeah,
but then like after that, you got to think about that all the time.
I like Ginge, man.
Or
I like Ginge.
After that, right? No, he cream pies her.
That's ridiculous.
Why are we adding more?
No,
why are we adding more?
Because it's the baby aspect as well.
What?
So now I have a ginger baby.
that's a bad way of putting it. So he gives her a baby, not cream pies her.
Yeah, but that cream pie leaves the baby.
Impregnate.
I thought a cream
so
pie.
So we're not having safe sex?
No, not safe.
Unsafe sex.
This is cum sex, mate.
It would have to be ginge. It would have to be.
So, okay, and then they give a little birth to a little ginger baby.
And then that's Ginger's responsibility, no?
It's true.
Come on, that's not. I'm not. Don't put that on me.
Okay,
that's Ginger's responsibility.
Yeah,
I'm not. But I'm not bringing up a ginger child, mate.
No,
never.
I wouldn't.
Never.
Okay, what would you pick?
I would pick. I don't really have many enemies. Many enemies.
Okay, let me think. Who don't you like?
Well, were you going to say? Are you? What?
Oh no, I won't say.
I don't like
name drop.
So it's either my best mate or Danny Aaron's fucking mate.
And it's not the same person.
I would go with, it's massive betrayal though, isn't it?
Well, either way, it is what it is, mate, isn't it?
I think I'd rather the enemy. Because then you lose two people.
But you already don't have the enemy. Don't lose.
No. If your best mate shagged her, you'd lose your best mate and Tennessee.
What?
Why is 10 here?
you're not going in with me.
I've got something to tell you, mate. It's I thought we were all shagging her. I don't know.
Your girlfriend.
Well, you'd lose.
Okay, me. Yeah. I'm not saying I'm your best friend, but let's just say me, because I'm just thinking about that scenario.
Either you or an enemy.
Mm.
I'll let you do it. Just because I know you'd like it.
That wasn't hypothetical. That was a serious nightmare. Yeah.
Fine. Go on then.
All right, so this Jack Doherty.
Yeah.
How do you even say it? Jack,
I think it's Irish, isn't it? Jack Doherty.
Doherty. Is he Irish?
No, he's American. Of course he's American.
How old is he? He's your age.
He's 20. He's
younger than you. Would you...
About 5'1", though.
Is he small?
Yeah, fucking twerp, man.
Would you fight him?
Yeah, no, I'm literally trying to. I've been DMing mams. I've been DMing, like, no, I'm like, it's not happening. Like, I don't think it's happening.
Why not?
Like,
has he replied?
But this is the issue. He keeps replying like, oh, you don't want me, little bro. You don't want this. Oh, you can't knock me out. And then I'm like, oh, cool. I'm DMing Misfits. I'm DMing mams who like runs it all. I'm like, dead serious. Let's run it. The latest we've got is, doesn't look like it's going to happen, but we'll get you some other options. And I'm like,
what, from his side?
Yeah, but I want, there's a Misfits on Saturday. I will fight on that. I will fight. I will fight him
right now.
I don't give a fuck. I'd have him tonight.
Sick.
But like, it's just not happening. It's not happening. He doesn't want it. He's just talking, innit? He's just talking.
Has he not even got to like negotiate?
Nah. But I don't give a fuck about that. Like, generally, I'm not doing this for money. I just want to slam him, mate. I just want to kill
him. Has he done something personal or you just don't like him?
He's a wanker. He hasn't done anything. No, he hasn't said anything. But like, he's just a wanker.
Do you reckon you could bang him out?
Yes. No, look, come on. 1,000,000%. Right. I mean, there's not a doubt in my mind that I don't knock him out. I mean that. There's not a single doubt.
Versus Angry Ginge.
Oh, and that would be a good fight.
Yeah, we've spoke about that. We've spoken, but obviously it would be with like good intentions.
Yeah,
it would be like I'm going in there to kill him. Like,
like a charity match or something.
Yeah.
But you kind of have to.
Is that I hear that's him there. That's that dog.
He's a teeny tiny bitch.
Oh, he has an OnlyFans, by the way.
He's not big.
He has an OnlyFans.
Wait, he's joking. A gimp then.
There's an OnlyFans.
Not no disrespect to OnlyFans people.
Does he do on OnlyFans?
I think he does like feet.
Oh,
I think.
Jesus.
I'll be honest, I'm not signing up to his OnlyFans.
Massive
fans,
disrespect to him then.
But yeah, he looks
a bit bigger. Have you seen the video of the island boys
sucking off with
each other? No. There's a video on Twitter of one sucking the other one off.
That's
you seen that?
No, of course I have not.
Watch it.
I'm not watching that.
Nah, trust me, you like it.
You lot watch some weird stuff, man.
I didn't say I watched that.
You said you watched a doctor putting his
cock in.
That was crazy. I can't believe that.
It was on the news.
You showed me a video of a guy stabbing someone's heart out their chest.
No, nice. I remember that.
You're pretty fucking mental.
That was a cartel. Yeah, that was pretty mad.
The cartel are fucked.
Either way.
All right, next hypothetical. I can't see shit. Can you guys see that?
He's got his new contacts in.
Okay, all right. I got it. Who would survive longer in a zombie apocalypse? Tell us your strategy.
Good man.
Well done.
And why you would... What the fuck?
Someone
else read this. I don't have my glasses today.
Yeah, that's not going to be now, is it?
You read that.
Okay. Who would survive longer in a zombie apocalypse? Tell us your strategy and why you would outlast the other. What do you think each other's downfall would be? Right.
So who would last the longest?
I think you'd last the shortest.
Fuck!
Because I can't run.
Yeah.
You said it.
Yeah.
You said it.
No. I can run.
But that's not the issue. I feel like it's not just running. It's like using
your
brain.
Okay, what's the issue then?
Using your brain. Yep. Like,
don't eat him.
Okay. Right, no, okay. So there's a zombie apocalypse. What are you doing?
Oh, I'll fucking tell you what I'm fucking doing.
Right now, go on.
Right. So where am I then?
You're in the field.
You're in the middle of nowhere.
Yep.
Yeah.
Forest.
Well, let me tell you one thing. So this is intelligent. That's probably the best place to be because there's not going to be people around there. Low footfall, geographical word.
It's quite intelligent. I don't know what that means, but...
Right.
Exactly. Do you know what footfall means?
Yeah, it's a geographical word.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay. I don't know that word.
Right. Yeah, but the thing is, right, so you're in a field full of zombies.
No, it's not full of zombies. That's what I'm saying.
But it would become full of zombies.
No, it wouldn't.
Because they smell you.
Can they smell you?
100%.
Okay, but...
Zombies can do a lot, man.
Yeah.
And these zombies will go to eat animals in the wild. No.
There you go.
Okay. Well, all right. I'll tell you what I'll do then. So, all right. So just a random field. What I'd do is I'd go to a farm because in the UK, they're the only people that are allowed to legally carry weapons.
Or the police.
No, but then that would be in the police state.
No, but I feel like, hear me out, when there's a zombie apocalypse, there's not laws.
No, that's no, no. True. No.
Like, yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like,
well, here's how I've out-intelligenced you here.
Okay.
Because it is in law, but where else are you going to find a gun?
You can find places, man.
There's no black market.
You can find some places.
Where's the black market?
In London. Go south of London, mate.
All right. Yeah. What do you
go
mean?
Go to the ends, man.
Go to the ends.
Okay, right. Back me up here. If you go to South London, a highly populated area, there's going to be millions of zombies feasting.
Yeah, I'd argue you'd want to be in a populated place.
That's insane.
I'd argue. There's more competition.
And resources.
More resources. There's more. Well, like there's loads of like, zombies, but there's also loads of humans, right?
Would there be though?
The start. Oh, then you could like let the zombies have all the other people and while you
run away.
Run away and make your own plan.
Where would you run away to though?
I have a secret bunker in Hawaii.
But you can, okay. So we can just make up places in this thing.
Well, it's literally a hypothetical,
yeah,
which is true. What you're supposed to do is
okay,
make up.
Okay, fine. Stuff, right? I will build a tank and I'd build a huge fortress. That's
no, but that's unrealistic.
I can
realistically get a flight to Hawaii.
Yeah.
No, and you cannot yourself. In a zombie apocalypse.
Of course
apocalypse.
I can. Of course
he
can I
do
can.
What he wants.
Sorry, there was barely flights in the COVID.
Yeah, well, but I fly private.
There you go. Right. What I'll do that's more realistic then is I'd go to the nearest fancy dress shop and I would buy all the fake blood and I would buy like pig shit. And I would smear me in pig shit.
Pig shit in the fancy dress shop.
Well, I'd find
where are you getting the pig shit from?
The farm.
Right, I'd shit myself then.
Right.
And I'd rub it on me, right? And then I'd squirt blood all over me and I'd go, right? And I'd walk around like a zombie.
That's quite smart, actually.
That's insane.
No, you've got to respect that. That's smart.
The virus will know that you're living and it will want to spread to you.
Right.
That's how zombies work.
Yeah, you're both right.
Thank you.
But you'll survive longer because you just said, I'm going to a farm.
No, I didn't finish myself.
Because there's legal guns.
I'm going to a farm. I'm killing the farmers, taking their weapons, building a bunker
but
under the farm.
Surely the farmers would have the guns.
I'll kill them.
But they have a gun.
Okay, yeah, but farmers are like 80 years old.
Fine.
They don't know how to work. They can kill pheasants. They can't kill me.
I believe in you. Fine.
It's a hypothetical.
Well,
right?
Moving on.
They don't
moving
kill
on.
Me in this. I kill the farmers in this.
Moving on. I wanted to say a story, right?
Here we go.
It's weird. It's a deep. Weird one. It's a deep one, be, right?
Yeah. Okay.
And it's fucked. It's a bit fucked. I hope they watch this. So I got a DM literally a few days ago. And it said something like, oh, you're right, Carl. You met my friend the other month and he's just killed himself. Right. Right, yeah.
Sorry.
No.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Right.
And I was like, fuck, that's mad. That is mad. Rest in peace, guy.
And you reply that.
This
is mad. This is fucking mad.
And I saw the picture of me and him and everything, right? All uploaded to TikTok. And then I DM the guy who's supposed to be dead.
What?
And he replies. And he's not dead.
Wait. Why did you DM someone?
Yeah, because was dead. Right, I can explain. Because
are you actually dead, bro?
Gone too soon, man.
As if he's gonna read it. Because his mate, I was like, oh shit, how do you know he's dead? And he was like, oh yeah, because he like blocked everyone and he's like, he's fucked. He said he's going to commit suicide. He sent me this video of him being like, oh yeah, I'm fucking over it and all that. Anyway, and then I was like, oh shit. And then he was like, actually, I don't know if he is dead. So I was like, right, well, why say it then? So I DM'd him and I was like,
are you dead?
Are you dead? No, I just said, are you okay, bro? And
that's nice of you, man. Yeah.
And then he replied straight away. It was like, yeah, you're right. I'm buzzing.
He just wanted to reply.
And I was like, right, this is fucked. Why would the fuck would you say your friend is dead? That's ridiculous.
And he was absolutely fine.
He's fine. But people say they're fine, don't they?
Mm.
So I actually said to him, I was like, your mate said you're like fucked, basically. And
you're the last person I'd want DMing me if I was in that state.
And then he said, yeah, actually, I've been a bit under the weather. Bit ill with it, and I was like, right, well, just keep your head up high, boy.
Good man.
And just live.
Yeah.
just live it out.
If you're watching,
we're here for you, man.
We're here for you.
We're here for you. So live it out. Don't ever constrain to society.
Damn.
What's the relevance of that?
Damn.
I don't know what that
Andrew
means.
Tate is here.
So yeah, that's my story. And I just think that's a bit fucked. No. That you, why would you say that about your friend?
Yeah, it's weird.
Have you ever experienced any death?
I haven't died yet, man. No, I'm chilling.
You must get a lot of people come up these days.
What? How's that related?
What?
I get people like, oh, you know, your things help me. And yeah, I'm like, oh, that's right. Sweet. Like, I like that. That's like a, you don't really realize, but yeah, that's like a nice little bonus. You help people out, you know?
Yeah, you never realize that. Why is it helping you out?
It's just distraction, isn't it?
Like, yeah, distraction.
Like when I'm down bad or whatever, I'll just whack on YouTube and I'm like, oh, this is calm.
Yeah.
You know? So it's just what people do, isn't it?
Like, have you ever had a weird like follower interaction?
I'll be honest, I don't like, when I see weird stuff, I just wouldn't reply or anything. Like,
No, in real life?
Nah, not really, man. Like my fans are calm, mate.
I feel like really... you've got like the little fucking lads.
Yeah, I got like the Chavez and that. Like I ain't really got... I'm sound, man. Like they're all very nice, respectful. Like, that, you know, the thing is, people like with my content and that, it's like very self-deprecating. So like they'd also do that, and I'm like, yeah, calm. Do you know what I mean? This is what we do.
Yeah.
So like they don't mean it, but yeah.
I feel that a lot of hate. I think girls get more hate in this.
Oh
industry,
yeah.
Definitely. Oh, like appearance and that. 100%.
Oh yeah. 100%. Because I was on like a little. Did you just kiss your teeth?
I fucking.
So I was on a ski trip, and we're going into this club. We had to do this club appearance, which I don't like, to be fair, because it's just weird. We've done one, didn't we? Mm. And then we're walking to the club, and we got in there, and look at all the girls. Like, should I name them?
Nah.
Right.
Nah.
All the girls were like, oh, they've just been fucking me up and that and slating me. One got a snowball to the face.
Yeah.
And I was there like...
It's how the boys work, man. It's how they work. I mean, that's their way of saying, hey, I like you.
Yeah.
You know what's weird as well? I think like a lot of girls don't understand how guys talk to each other.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean? Like, even if I've just met a guy, I'll roast him because that's kind of how you bond with a guy.
It's the fact, like how the time that, like, if I just met you, 2 minutes with boys, like two girls, they'd probably have to like have a whole fucking process,
heart and all that.
We're like, mate, I see a man down the street.
Suck him up.
You know what I mean? Like we're boys.
Yeah, so that's what it is. Because we've had clips like go up. And there's a lot of girls commenting like, oh, they're being so inappropriate because we take the piss out of like the guys that come on.
It's just the lads, isn't it?
And it's
just the lads.
Well, the thing, right, let me say, can I say this?
I don't know. What is it? What are you going to say? What is it?
Well, we had someone on our podcast, right?
What?
And we said to him, we said about like threesomes and stuff.
Anyway,
we said about threesomes and it was a clip. And then this was a guy. And then the comments were like, oh, you can see he looks so uncomfortable. This is fucking well out of order. Like, blah, blah, blah. It's so sexist, and all that shit. He went on another podcast, someone else's podcast.
A girl's podcast, right?
Yeah.
And she asked him one of, like, almost the exact same question, like, about sex or like, oh, would you fuck this, blah, blah, blah. And all the girls were like, this is so funny. Yeah. Like, so,
different audience, isn't it?
Like, yeah, weird, isn't it?
It's weird, isn't it? It's like, but... It's annoying that when we said, like, because that's how guys chat.
Yeah.
And bear in mind,
he's our mate.
He wasn't
uncomfortable. He's our friend.
Yeah.
It's weird.
But even he said, he was like, why are people being weird about it?
Yeah.
People get offended on other people's behalf.
It's so weird.
Like, that's just the internet now. Like, they'll find a problem.
You don't get much hate, though, do you?
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah. Oh, come on, man.
Really?
You ain't on Twitter. Twitter finds someone to hate every like 3 months.
Yeah.
This is me right now.
Genuinely,
I'm on the 3 months right
it.
Now, man.
Wow.
No, but I love it. Like I probably shouldn't, but like when I get hate, I like it and like, you know.
Oh, really?
And what I found out now, because I've had like my mates text me like, oh, I just saw this on like my Twitter. Because when I like it, it shows to my followers, Danny Aaron's this. So I found out when I'm liking it, it's
backing you up.
It's basically retweeting it.
Yeah.
So like, no, but I love it, man. Like, I feel like hate is don't get me wrong, it's not, I'd love if the world was just all positivity and that, but we need hate.
Yeah.
We need hate. Because realistically, if we don't get hate, our egos, everything, that's they're true. Fucking gone. You need to have people just to humble you, you know?
100%, so, that's true. Yeah, I experienced hate on Twitter. It's fucked.
Yeah.
Really, really bad.
Yeah.
Did you, because you were memed a lot, weren't you, when you were in Tennessee?
Oh, mate, it was like... I was popping, man. I was trending. Danny Aarons was trending.
Really?
Fucked, man.
That's great. What does she think about that?
See, this, like, we're both like very similar. Like, because the thing is, like, obviously, we're in the public eye. Mm. It's gonna get a lot of attention, but like, it also is a real thing. Do you know what I mean? So, like, as I said, like, people saying, "Oh, get her on stream, get her on a video, do this, do that." I'm like, cool. Let's just chill. Do you know what I mean?
Do
like,
what you want.
This is a real thing.
Are like, you going to try just, and keep it private?
That's the, like, I feel like we can't really. Yeah, like, we are difficult. Both in the public eye. So like, but like, yeah, I'm not trying to milk her. Do you know what I mean? I'm not trying to go like, well, no, I'm not trying to like,
yeah. Oh, I would.
Like, instead of going like, oh, Ten, do you want to go on a date?
Yeah.
Not, oh, Ten, do you want to come around stream? Do you know what I mean? Like, this isn't like a fucking business. Like,
yeah.
Because that ruins relationships.
100%.
Do you remember like those partner vlogs?
Yeah.
Do you remember like BFSG?
Yeah.
And like,
stuff like that. It's just, nah, it's you can't operate like that. Like an actual loving relationship. You can't
be behind the scenes, yeah. Really, innit?
So there's a nice balance, innit? Like, I'm sure, don't get me wrong, like, she'll definitely be in a stream or a video sometime, but like,
what the fuck?
You good?
What?
This isn't even alcohol.
What is it?
This is dirty water.
No, it ain't.
This is water.
No, it ain't.
Try
is
that.
It?
I put that some in my drink
that
the other
is.
Day.
That's dirty.
Try it. Try it. It's literally
that's water,
mate.
Is that gravy?
I don't know what the fuck it is. Like tea.
Oh, that stinks.
Wait, do you want to try that?
Let me smell. Let me smell.
That ain't I'd alcohol. Definitely it. Not.
Please try
yeah,
it.
No, I'm, that
please.
Stinks, man. That stinks.
That absolutely
smells
agrees.
Like sewage.
Give it to him.
That smells like sewage.
I think that is dirty water.
It's literally.
Go on,
it's
bottoms up.
I don't know.
You fed it to us.
Please try it.
It smells like fucking mop water.
I know.
Is that mop water?
It smells like mop water.
Is that just aesthetic?
I drank it. And I put that in my drink the other day because I thought it was alcohol. And I was sipping it thinking, this don't taste like fucking alcohol. What the hell?
That's fucking rank.
Right, what's that then?
I was going to say, speaking about DMs and like you get blowing up and shit.
Yeah.
Have you had like famous people DM you?
Like mega.
I feel like DMs are different. I've had like follows, but yeah. I feel like DMs like, nah, nothing, no one I can really be like, oh my God, this guy DM'd me. Do you know what I mean? Like,
what about a Sidemen? Does that KSI and all that?
Yeah, but we're boys, man.
We're boys.
Don't get me wrong, I'm not like fucking KSI's best friend, obviously, but like,
yeah, but
we would speak before. Anyway.
Do you just chat to them?
No, I would say I'm very close in the Sidemen. I'm not very close, but I'm close to Simon, Bez, and Josh. They're my boys. They're
who
my
do
boys.
You think? I saw a clip today of like the Tottenham squad doing this.
Yeah.
She was like, who is the most famous person in your contacts you could call and they'd answer?
I could call and answer.
And then answer.
Fuck.
Yeah.
And answer.
Yeah.
I ain't really got a phone book like that, man. Because
on Instagram. Any way you can call them.
No, because I'm going to say a name and you're going to be like, oh, fucking call them.
Yeah,
no,
that's what's happening here right now.
I'm trying to keep it like realistic.
Go on.
Could you ring, because I saw Chunks in Philly did this as well.
Okay.
And he was like, oh yeah, I'm boys with KSI.
I could phone KSI, but I'm not, because I don't phone people. So like when he answers, what do?
Then you just be like,
not phone people.
Yeah,
I phone
then,
nobody.
Then
I phone
yes,
nobody.
I know. Yeah, but then you'll just be like, oh, it's just a test. And you pass it.
I could text anyone and they'd reply, but I'm
it's
not.
Be phone.
I ain't phoning. I do not phone people.
Yeah, but just it's an emergency.
You know,
it's an emergency.
Right, so like I'm moving house and I have to set up new internet, doing it all on email. And they're like, cool, last stage. We got a phone to, you know, finalize everything. I ain't phoned them for 2 weeks. I'm moving in 2 days.
Okay.
I don't phone people.
Okay, well, what if you phone them and they pick up, you can hang up?
Yeah.
Just say it was an accident.
No, that's just...
He knows KSI won't answer.
No, I promise you he will. I promise you
KSI ain't answering.
I promise you he will.
If KSI is not answering Chunks...
I promise you...
You think he'd answer you at
Chunks? Prove it.
No.
I promise you he... I text him right now, he'll reply within 5 minutes.
No, he won't.
Go on in.
You don't think he'll reply in 5 minutes?
Go on.
Yeah, you.
And it can't be something like you need to reply to this. Like,
no, I'll literally, text him, yo.
Yeah, go on.
Promise you, he'll respond in 5 minutes.
Who's the biggest you could do?
Well, I reckon. I've done Ricky already.
Yeah, but he barely replies.
He
just puts thumbs up.
Yeah, true.
I'll give it 2 minutes.
I reckon.
See the message?
I literally just text him, yo.
Okay.
Yo.
Okay.
Okay.
What time is that?
17:17.
Okay.
I reckon I've got Philly's number, but I know that you'd answer. I don't
try it.
No, it'd be like, who's this? But I reckon maybe Deji would answer.
You got Deji? Yeah, that's Deji's fucking number. Love Deji, man. Yeah. I ain't even.
I've called him before and he's answered.
I don't think he likes me.
Yeah, well,
why
doesn't like me?
Well, when we saw him at the Sidemen event, he came up to you and chatted to you. I was like, yo, you up, boy? And he was like, yeah. And then carried on chatting to you.
Really?
Up, man?
Yeah.
And I was like, oh,
Deji's such a nice guy.
Yeah,
he's my favorite, that. Man.
Yeah.
He's one of my, he's top three for me.
Who, okay, out of the Sidemen then?
What?
What?
Rate the Sidemen.
Rate the Sidemen.
Yeah.
In terms of what?
In terms just of fucking
looks.
No. Like, who's your boys? Who'd you hate?
I don't hate. I love all the Sidemen.
I'm joking.
I love all the Sidemen.
What would you like your closest to?
He said,
yeah, Simon, Bez, Josh.
Are you in this
that's
conversation?
Top three.
He said these.
Simon, Bez, Josh.
Jesus Christ.
And then, like, probably then Toby.
Toby's
sick. Harry or Toby's fourth, yeah.
Mm.
But I love them all.
Yeah, they all
I love them all.
Yeah. I'd say KSI, like,
Here we go.
When, no, I'm not arsing it. I'm not arsing it. I'm just saying, when I met him in person, he's very different, isn't he? He's like very, like,
he's very nice.
Polite,
he's very
really nice. Like, he came up to me.
That was an ego booster.
Sorry, did he go up to you?
He was just standing next to me, bro.
Did he?
Yeah.
Sick. Okay, fair enough. Who's the most famous in your contact?
Oh, fucking hell.
Actually, I know who you've got.
Well,
he wouldn't answer, though.
Who?
You've got fucking.
In what?
My actor.
Jared Leto.
Yeah. He's got Jared Leto. Yeah,
he'd answer me.
Who's that?
You don't know Jared Leto?
I don't watch films.
What the fucking Joker? You ever heard of the Joker, mate?
Was he the Joker?
The Joker.
Not the Joker.
He was the Joker.
The one that won the... Oh, I don't know who that is.
He's
you've
fucking,
never seen him?
Nah.
You ever,
why did you have
that
him?
Joker there?
Although he was in the shittest film, which was...
Well, no, I actually loved that film.
No. He was in a really shit film.
Morbius.
Morbius
no,
is
we
the
did
worst,
a, we did a deal
best film ever. Baby boy. The worst film.
Can ring
sorry.
Drake.
Drake follows him, yeah.
We got a few
oh,
messages.
Oh, yeah, he DM'd you or some shit, right?
Yeah,
you put your rule or whatever. That's fucked.
That's cool.
That's, that's massive.
Should I try calling him?
Should I call Drake? Come on.
If on you... Instagram?
Yeah.
It's never going to work.
Yeah, no, he might do. Imagine if he
imagine
does.
Imagine
yeah.
if
he... Come on.
Oh,
if he,
no, that's
if he
well...
calls Drake, you call KSI.
Actually, okay. if he picks up. Right,
yeah, Drake is not going to pick up.
No, but imagine.
Do it.
Yeah.
But imagine. Then, forget I'm here.
I think I'll
special
throw
guest
up.
Drake is in the title.
Yeah, I think I'll him. Throw up if he answers.
Well, do it then.
That's don't even think about it. Just
that's
do it.
That's insane. I'm just going to. Oh, fucking hell.
Just do it.
This segment is called Calling Drake.
Okay, I'll try calling Drake.
But on Instagram.
Yeah,
like, that's not even. You don't get a notification or anything.
Oh, he my will. God. All right.
But he follows it.
You're nervous. Like he's.
Yes, I am nervous. This is Drake.
He's not picking up.
Go on.
What do I do?
Just do video call.
This is going to be
if
awkward.
If he picks up, Cole, what do I do?
Well, you just say,
like the music, man.
He's not going to pick up a gun. Here we go.
He's actually nervous, by the way.
Imagine if he picked up. Keep going.
Why is I like how he's preparing.
Yeah.
Why he's actually...
Right, mate. Right, boy.
Why is it not? Anything? Maybe flick the thing on.
I don't know.
Flick the bean.
Flick the bean on. No, on the side. Flick that up.
Stop pressing shit.
He's stressed.
He's not going to answer, is he?
Well.
No. Well, he's
anti-climax.
Sorry, JJ's still not
texted
me back, so we're still nil. Do you know what I mean? We're
Champagne still Pappy has not answered me. Call ended. There we go.
Now he's going to have notifications then.
But what time is it in Canada? There's always that to think
good
about.
Point, yeah.
Oh. Call Deji and ask if he likes Jack.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
No
that's
way. No.
We've both done it.
I just called fucking Drake, man.
Come on.
No.
We've both done it.
If he unfollows me after that,
I'll call
be
Philly. Because I've
Philly ain't going to answer you. He
you might
you.
Do. You, what, you thought Drake would?
No, I didn't.
Because I'll shall I see about Philip?
You must have had footballers DM you and shit.
I've got like footballers follow me. Yeah. But like,
you chat, you don't chat to them.
If someone follows me, I'm not DMing them. Like, oh, thanks for the follow, man.
Oh, I do. But
I can't do that.
I do that every time.
Nah.
No, you don't. You don't even text me.
Yeah, but you're not Drake.
Right. Should I, what should I say to Philly if he answers in?
Just start a chat. See what he says.
Just call him. Talk. Just checking up on you, man.
Yeah.
That was
so funny. Go
what
on.
The hell? I barely speak to the guy.
How you doing, man? All good?
Yeah, he'll like that.
That is a bit of Philly. Philly would love just a check up.
He ain't going to answer.
Do you reckon?
No, does he even know it's you? Has he ever answered you?
Hello? Oh, no. Phil?
Yo.
Yay! Come on, lad. Phil, it's Cole, by the way. It's Cole Anderson. I know you probably...
What's happening, Cole? Yeah. Fucking hell, bro.
Mate, I know you didn't have my number saved, but we're on the pod, right? And we're going through like who's the biggest person in your contact list. You gave me your number, by the way. This isn't weird, but you gave it to me, yeah?
I remember. I gave it to you at the PLT party.
That's it. Yeah, you did, right? You didn't save it, weird. But anyway, and then I said, I reckon I could call Philly. I don't know if he'll answer.
100%. I got mad love for you, Cole, man. Do you remember what I said to you that day in the party as well?
No, what did you say?
I said, I'll come down on a pod one day if you invite me.
Oh, and you know what I said? I said, get your fucking ass down here. I've invited you a million times. You've got Danny Aaron's here at the moment.
My brother, Phil.
What's happening, Danny?
My boy. Danny. Speak to you again, man. How you doing, man?
My boy, Jack.
Danny, guess who I'm with?
Who are you with? Ginge.
I'm with Ginge.
Nah, you're not. What?
Yeah.
My boy.
Tell him who else is here, boy.
Oh, Jack Joseph.
Who is it?
Ginge.
I don't know if it's Cole, but Danny Aaron's is on their pod. Just say hello, bro.
Hi,
Ginge.
Right, Ginge.
Like his sports, like
his
mum.
Yeah.
Oh, you know Cole, mate. Oh, yeah?
Yeah, of course.
Of course he knows me. Anyway, that's literally it, boys. Yeah.
You don't have your number saved.
I know, mate. I fucking know. And I know you answered it on mute as well.
Now. Oh, do you know what I'm going to do as well? Go I'm going to give you Tom's number because she does my diary and then just to ask her when I'm my next free and then just book it in with her, yeah?
All right, yeah. What's her name?
Maria.
All right, Maria. Sick one. Yeah, give me that, all right?
Man said fit one. He's a fucker. But yeah, I'm going to send you a number now, brother, yeah?
All right, sick one, mate.
Am I actually the most famous person in your country?
No, you're not. Ricky Gervais is. Now, fuck off.
See you later, bro.
See you later, mate.
Love, brother.
Oh, there we go. Now you got a ring KSI.
Well, no, he's already texting us.
Yeah, he's not replying.
Well, that was good. He loves you.
He didn't have my number saved, though.
No.
He will now, though.
I suppose.
He will now, maybe.
Well, we can either go on that or we can either do the last segment, which is...
Oh, yeah.
We have time. People coming in. Danny Aaron's winning on to a good deal.
You could do both.
Okay, let's go on to that quickly. Let's mention that since we have you here.
So,
apparently a lot of people on Digga D's new music video. Have you seen the comments?
Nah, I mean, I'm not really going on his page, to be honest with you. No offense. Yeah.
The guy that's like raw
sure
dog.
You know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
he would have though.
Yeah, no, 100%.
Exactly. Nice he would have.
100%.
Yeah. Apparently he's commenting all the comments are Danny Aaron's W.
Wow.
On
hey, I got the boys backing me, man.
You do have the boys.
I got the boys backing me.
He probably likes you, actually.
Do you? I don't know about
that. I won't go that far.
Actually, not, then, no.
I won't go that far, but the boys,
I've never listened to Digga D's stuff.
Nah, what
does he do?
He's like a rapper.
He's a rapper, I think. No, of course he's a rapper.
Is he a rapper or a singer?
No, he's not a singer.
What, Digga D?
He can't be a singer.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's different.
Oh, he's quite
that
hard.
That is different. Yeah. That's a different look.
It's aura.
He looks scary.
I mean,
Digga D. What's his net worth? You're probably worth more than Digga D.
See, this is it, man. I don't want to be that guy.
Mm.
Yeah.
I got more.
Really?
Yeah. I got more, man.
Yeah, you must have. I don't know what this...
I get more from my coin sponsor.
There you go.
Do you coin sponsors?
I do coin sponsors.
I wanted to ask you this.
Money.
So do you, when you do these FIFA things, do you buy FIFA points or you just use coins?
No, I buy points, yeah.
How much have you bought?
I've toned it down this year. Last year it was like 70 grand.
That's insane.
No, but mate, people will be like, oh, what a waste of money. It's an investment.
It is an investment. It's your job.
It's like a builder buying tools, Rick, mate.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I've got to do, man.
I packed Mbappe a month ago. Thank you.
Well done. Well done, man. I'm proud of you.
I didn't spend that much. I spent
a grand. He still spent.
Yeah, like this year, I don't do because obviously I'm moving away from FIFA, so not doing as much. But
good lad.
But I saw you're looking at buying an R8.
Well, that's the issue. Like, I'm obviously moving London now. I feel like having an R8 in London, like, dead, isn't it? Driving 20 miles an hour, like, so that will probably be when I settle down a little bit.
What do you drive now?
Tesla.
Do you like
everyone
it?
Everyone drives
him. Yeah, Tesla's perfect.
Tax write-off as well, isn't it?
Mate, I bought it.
Oh.
What do you mean? Company bought it, man.
Yeah.
It's a company car, isn't it?
Yeah, that's true.
It's a company car. So yeah, that's
electric's the future.
Literally perfect, man. Like, perfect.
Have you made like a crazy purchase yet?
Like a watch?
I have
watches. A watch is kind of an investment.
I wouldn't say I have like anything
crazy.
Stupid.
Mm. You're smart, you're mad.
Like, literally, personally, I do not buy it. The only thing Danny Aarons buys is food.
Yeah.
Everything else, the company sort of.
Same with me.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah, like, same.
Well, even my company buys my food.
Yeah, yeah. But sometimes if I'm doing a little mukbang, hey.
There we go.
Limited companies all over that, mate.
Yeah. But apparently they're cracking down on influencers.
Fuck them.
Like, they are doing a lot with tax. Like, they're taxing like people selling their clothes and that.
Yeah. Apparently, if a company gifts you clothes, right? So let's say the Sidemen send you their hoodie.
Yeah.
You've got to pay tax on that hoodie.
You've got to pay VAT, yeah.
What?
How crazy is that?
How the fuck are they going to know?
It's stupid.
Just don't tell them, I suppose.
Yeah.
The last segment of the show, ladies and gentlemen, is called Who's Punching? You have sent in to our email a picture of you and your lovely spouse. And we decide, well, who's uglier, basically.
Well, so, they're punching, yeah.
Yeah.
Or sure. Who is punching?
But is punching all about looks?
No.
Do you know what I mean?
No, isn't this because it's a
picture?
Do you know
what I mean?
No. You can, a picture tells a million words.
That
and
is
I think
not the saying.
You can tell a person's personality from their picture, I reckon.
Okay, we can
depends
do
on
that.
The vibe, innit?
The vibe.
Depends
we can
on
do
the
that.
Vibe.
Right, so now, here we have someone. We're going to put this on the screen.
Yeah.
Because, by the way, you sending in your pictures, you've given consent.
Yeah, this is fair game. We can say anything.
Now. If you send in pictures, you kind of give us permission to roast you.
Yeah. So it's your own fault.
That's a tricky one.
That is a tricky one.
I don't think it's tricky.
That's very tricky.
I
He kind of looks a little bit like me.
He does a little bit.
So I have to watch out.
So she...
She looks like she'd be...
This is hard.
What I'm saying is, she looks like she'd be a really pleasant person.
She'd be jolly.
You're calling her ugly, by the way. You're calling her ugly.
She looks nice. She just had her hair done.
She's got roots,
it's
mate.
The cheeks,
her roots
though,
are
isn't
black.
It? The cheeks are red.
But no.
No, Cole, the black roots is fashionable now.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Right?
This is offensive. This is offensive.
No, I like
I
her.
Actually, no, I think he's punching then.
I think he's punching with her.
I'd say it's actually very close. Like, I'll be honest, I'll say it. Media reaction was, fuck, she's punching hard. But now I'm analysing it.
Now
I think they're suited, man. I think they've done very well.
I think you've done
very well. I think he's punching.
I would say he's punching.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you?
I'd say he's punching. I actually would say
flipping
he's punching.
Hell yes.
Yeah, I flipping think that as well.
Good.
He Move on.
He's punching. Very slightly.
Very, very slight. Okay.
Ooh.
He is punching to fuck. Although she...
No, he's an attractive man.
Is he?
No, he is an attractive man.
His top lip is weird.
No, that is an attractive man.
He looks like Chip. A little bit.
He doesn't.
His mouth, he's got that little gimpy mouth.
Yeah, he's got like a weird teeth.
Mm. He looks like a more mature Chip.
He looks lanky and skinny.
He kind of looks like Chip and Cal combined.
Yeah,
he does.
Get him on the fellas, because that is them.
That is Chip and Cal. Yes, he does. That is weird.
That's a good couple.
But his girlfriend's, I think she's pretty. She's way prettier than
a lot of makeup.
Yeah, that's true.
A lot of makeup.
That's true.
Not that it's a bad thing.
Not a bad thing. We're not saying it's a bad thing.
People love makeup. I love makeup.
So what
I think she, is that her real cheek?
I'm not sure.
No, because it, do you know
it
what I mean?
It does look sharp, innit?
It looks, no, I'm talking about this part. You know this
it's
part?
Very,
it's very
cheekbone, yeah.
Very yeah, bumpy. But I know people do that to their
That's a win-win, man. That's a good
yeah,
couple.
Yeah, that's cool.
You're a good couple.
I would say she's punching, personally.
You think
very she's slightly. Though. She's jabbing.
No,
she's poking.
I'd say he's punching.
No, I'd say he's poking.
That is an attractive man. It is.
Would you?
That what the hell?
That is an attractive man. The circle glasses.
Out of 10, what would you say he is?
That's an 8.
You'd say he's a
that's an 8 hell? Out of 10. That's an attractive man.
I'd say he's like a bit above average.
Nah.
He's
not bad.
Because you already know he's got a huge cock.
You reckon?
Yeah, he's quite tall. Got a huge
cock. That's true. It brings him up to 9 then.
All right, he's a 9.
Okay, fine. Well, we have different opinions on that. Next one.
Oh.
Interesting. She looks older than him a lot.
Can we zoom in on this, please?
They're an odd.
This is a weird vibe.
Oh, no, that's so easy.
Is it?
Is it?
He's punching hard.
Yeah.
He's punching majorly.
She's got a creepy aura. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. No, but that's kind of sexy.
Is it?
That's sexy.
It does look
like
a bit sexy.
That's sexy.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Like, oh, dominate me kind of sexy. Do you know what I mean? He is punching hard.
And he's younger than her. 100%.
Yeah.
She does look older. Yeah.
That's a cougar.
We like older women here, everyone.
Cougar. 100%.
Mm. Yeah?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What top is that?
Cortez.
Cortez. Is that a... Yeah, he's
like
rich.
It's a cringe.
Is it? No, it's expensive, isn't it?
That's Cortez.
Aiden, look. It's not Cortez. It's Couture, yeah.
It's Cortez.
No, it's Cortez.
Either way, let's do one more. Bro's punching. I think he's punching, yeah. Let's do one more.
There we go.
That's perfect.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
That is a good couple.
That's a good couple.
That's
a very good couple.
That is a couple you'll see walking down like Essex.
Nah, that's a couple you'll see at like a Weatherspoons.
Yeah. Well, yeah. What? They're poor now, are they?
No, they're not poor. But
Weatherspoons is a high-end
restaurant. Is what
you'll see like the Weatherspoons with a nice carpets and a dance floor.
Carry on. I just want to analyze her. So he's older than her.
Mm.
She looks quite young, but she's wearing a lot of makeup.
She looks like a nurse.
He's punching slightly.
He is.
That's a good couple, though.
He's got a good face. It's just the top of his ear comes a bit out.
Without the beard, he would be
grim.
Oh, beard saves him a
beard
lot.
Beard saves, yeah.
So well done, guys. You are the winning couple today.
Yeah. That is a power couple.
Well done.
So that...
We're going to get in a lot of trouble for that, aren't we?
Well, we'll review it.
Yeah.
We'll review it and take out the necessary parts. So, thank you guys
for watching.
Danny, what do you want to say to the cameras? Have you got anything coming?
I've got a lot of things coming, man. I'm coming hard.
Oh, nice.
Coming fast.
So look out for that.
Yeah, just look out. Yeah.
Where do they find you? I'm sure they know.
You can find me 5 channels on YouTube, Twitch, TikTok, Instagram. Just find me everywhere, man. Every social media, I'm there.
Dominated.
Snapchat, I'm on that now. I'm on the...
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's
Snap.
Where
I'm on the Snap. Yeah.
That's well good.
So, we're cooking, man. We're cooking.
Well, thank you very much for coming on.
Pleasure, boys. It's an absolute pleasure.
Oh, actually, before you go, we got a gift for you.
Oh, here we go.
No, it's real.
Okay.
It's real. So
take
this home with you. Right. So we know you're into your FIFA.
Yeah.
And your FIFA
points. I love my FIFA.
So we got
£10.
Got you some FIFA points.
I play on PlayStation, bro.
Oh, okay.
Oh, thank you very much.
Well, does Tennessee have a...
Tennessee doesn't.
She has a PlayStation as well.
Oh, brilliant.
But you know what?
On.
I'll give away this on stream.
Yeah.
I'll give this to someone on stream.
There we go.
Shout out.
Thank you. 100%,
can you confirm it's not been scratched?
No, it actually hasn't.
There we go.
It's not been scratched.
There we go.
Thank you very much.
And
you got another one?
The other thing you're big on is having a new girlfriend. So we've got you. Sex tips from 1894.
My boy.
Yeah,
why
there we
from
go.
1894?
Just because they're the classic.
They're the classic.
Well, that's very, very kind, lads.
Would you like to read some out?
Absolutely, mate.
Just read absolutely. First you, and then you'll get an idea.
Instruction and advice.
Yep.
That's a proper book.
It's proper.
Mm-hmm. To the sensitive young woman who has had the benefits of proper upbringing, the wedding day is unironically both the happiest and most terrifying day of her life. Where's the sex stuff?
that's in the next chapter, boy.
It's
all about weddings.
It genuinely is
all about weddings.
Nah, there'll be some sex stuff in there.
A good wife should expect to have reduced sexual contacts to once a week. Where's the tips?
It's just that's what it is.
That's boy. It.
That's what it is.
Most men are by nature rather perverted. And if given half a chance, would engage in quite a variety of the most revolting practices.
Yeah, I mean,
There you go.
Enjoy your
You're
gifts.
Welcome.
Thank you, boys.
All right.
That's very kind.
There you go.
Thanks for coming on.
See you later.
Check out all of his stuff.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
See you next time.